G'day, g'day! How the honk are ya? Welcome to Rover Land. This is your friend Dano, and it's a Wednesday. Yeah! What a Wednesday here on Rover Land. Yeah, and guess what we got today? Oh, I was just looking at this. I can't remember what side it is that we got to be on to flip it over to find out what it is. Remember this? Do you guys know what this is? Well, ba-bam! There, I picked the right side. Ha-ha! All right, we're looking at Dinky toys made in England. Now, this one is 1/43rd scale. This is number 282. And they've kind of got it listed. Now, it's a 109 wheel-based Land Rover. And they've kind of got it listed, Dinky Toys, Manico, England. And, model number 282 Land Rover 109 wheel-based fire service. Or firefighter, fire brigade, but the packaging that it comes in says fire appliance, Land Rover fire appliance. So that's what we're going to go with. Number 282 fire appliance from Dinky Toys. And obviously, being a one on Wednesday, this is the one and only one I've got. Isn't that miraculous? Now, I'm pretty sure I bought this off eBay. I don't know. I was looking on eBay, and these are called for pretty good prices. And as I was looking, to see, and it looks like mine is in pretty fair condition. There's a decal back here that says fire service. I have that. And then there's a decal on the door. And I do happen to have that. So, and the, of course, tricky part is getting them with the ladder. Now, the ladder, I believe, is metal, but the part that holds it, this here and this here, is plastic. And they break, and then therefore the metal ladder is gone. So here we go. Dinky Toys. This was produced 1974 to 1979. This is the only variation that I know of. This is Series 3, it looks like, by the... let's get in the frame here. Looks like a Series 3 by the look at the grill there. It does have jewel headlights in there. Other than that, there's no other markings or anything like that that is painted on. It did have a number plate decal up front here. I don't remember. I didn't write it down. But anyway, there is a decal there. Now, this one does have an opening hood feature, which is very, very nice. And, looks like a four-cylinder in there. Holy cow, what a workout for a four-cylinder where they have all this apparatus on there. But you can see they've got a battery there, other a little radiator here, little radiator cap there. Not really sure what that is supposed to be, but there's the engine with the filler cap. There is an exhaust manifold there. So pretty neat that way. The as we're going around here, we're going to just keep on the front here. The windshield does have wipers that are kind of molded in there. And if you can see that, there is kind of like a rear view mirror in there maybe. Or maybe it's just a tab for it. No, that's a rear view mirror like thing there. So let's turn over here to the side. Now this does have opening doors. And looks like it's going to be a right hooker because there's nothing here on the left side. But nice little doors. No glass in the window, obviously, just because, just because the way it is. Got to get the lighting here so my arm doesn't shadow it out. Sorry about that. This back part, now they did make another model of this with this casting. They made two, and the other one is a wrecker. So this whole back piece here, and you can kind of see how it kind of moves there, because that's just, I don't know if that's a screw or if that's a kind of a funny looking rivet there. But metal on metal, by the way. All this is metal except for like the interior is plastic and the bubbles on top. But yeah, just really a heavy model. Just a nice heavy model. But so the other variation is a wrecker. It has I don't have that one. I don't even know what number it is, but it is a wrecker. Now we turn it back to the back here, and you can see all the paraphernalia for the fire applicator. There's a pump there in the middle, and like hoses here on the sides, and he has a reel of hose back here. Pretty nice. I forgot to say, this is a little spotlight here. I think it's supposed to spin. Mine is glued in. I think that is supposed to spin. But yeah, like I say, mine is glued in there. Here is it. Now I am missing the steering wheel on the right hooker there. But the door shut really nice, and the hood. I mean, actually the doors don't stay shut when I turn it around and stuff like that. But it's got the gas cap over here. That's very nice detail. So all in all, very nice. There's another reel here, and this is all die cast of something. There's no real plastic parts on here except for that clip for the ladder, the interior, and the bubble and the glass, obviously, and you know, the funky jewel headlights there. But everything is metal on metal. Now there is something. Now these were produced from 1974 to 1979, and in my oh man, you know, there's no Wikipedia or anything on these, you know. So, in my limited looking around on the Google and eBay and stuff like that, now I did notice there are two types of wheels that can be found with this. I'm going to assume that this is the earlier type. This is a two-piece plastic with a metal center, plastic, hard plastic wheels. And then the second one, which I'm going to guess is the later model, came with, like what one lister said, was whiz wheels. And I thought that this particular model that came in a box with a little flap on the backside, a shadow box, the earlier models came with that, with these early, what I'm calling early wheels. And please, in the comments down below, help me out, figure out about the wheels. And then the later one with the whiz wheels, which are all plastic, came with a tray that a bubble top snapped onto. And but I found these with this wheel in the bubble top, and then I found the whiz wheels in the shadow box with the little bulletin board hanging on the top there. So I'm not really sure if you can really go by that. And I couldn't, they didn't have enough pictures to show you exactly of the boxes to see the years, if they even printed the years on there. So yeah, there you go. Well, so there it is, ladies and gentlemen, by One Up Wednesday. I did find on Toy Mart. Before I go, I got to tell you, toymart.com, and I think I mentioned these guys before when I did some of the other corgis and stuff like that, the police Valiant and stuff, but 2008, they were saying that these were valued in an A plus plus A condition. Were in 2008, we're going like $45 for these. That's U.S. dollars. And then now in 2019, they're just below $40 for these. So, but these seem to be readily available, like $50 over there, or 56 pounds or 60 pounds there in Great Britain. But you can get them brand new in the box yet. So they are kind of spendy, but you can still buy a complete in-the-box example. So pretty neat that way. But yeah, I know I didn't pay that much. I probably paid a pretty penny for this. I don't remember. I'm pretty sure I got it off eBay. But yeah, there we go. All right, well, there you go. Please comment down below. Give me a big thumbs. Can't even fit my thumbs in here. Give me two thumbs up on this video. Subscribe. Oh, we are growing. I appreciate everybody that has subscribed. And yeah, just keep subscribing. Go over on Facebook. I don't know why I'm pointing this way on Facebook. Maybe Facebook's over here. But go over to Roverland and join me up there. And Instagram, Roverland Channel. All right, that's come to it there, guys and gals. Remember, slow traffic, keep right, and have a wonderful, great, wonderful Rover day.